start the topic. Tenses. Can you tell me in how many zones has the time period been divided? Yeah, the time has been divided into three time zones. They are present, past, and future. These are three time zones. Right? So what you have written past here and present here. Time is like a timeline is what kind of timeline is it? It has no end, right? From there it started and it is going on. What do you call this in maths? From this side there might be some point to the end, but that side there is no end. So timeline can be broadly divided into three parts: past, present, and future. So past is whatever is over. Right now, what's the time? 9:16. Right now it is 9:16 AM of 27th July. 2021. 9:15 has also become past. Right? And right now, what I have spoken, that has also become past. Whatever the flickers of seconds they are getting over, they are also becoming past. Present is whatever is right now happening. And future is what is yet to come. Third period will be a future. So tomorrow is a future. The very 1 minute after this is a future. So present, past, present, and future. These are the three time zones. But when we broadly or closely look at the time, then we realize that it's not always exactly the present which is happening now. It's not always present, it's just not exactly this 1 second. I came in your class about 5 minutes ago. And 5 minutes ago, what I started, that is continuing right now, right? So there is some continuation. 5 minutes ago, I said something that has a relevance to the present. It's not that it's over, right? So there is some relevance with the past with present or present with future. So time zones are interconnected. So that's why these time zones have been further divided. And as per those divisions, there are 4 more components of these 3 time zones. Each time zone has 4 more components. One is indefinite. Okay, let's first try it out. First is indefinite. Second is continuous. I didn't have my mic. Why are they not speaking? Anyone? Yeah, because they've been muted. So that's the difference between you people and these people. But wherever you people are, I don't say that you are, yours is also good this season. Because more number of students might not be that safe. The better system will be when you, some of you come up and some of you don't come. Isn't it? Children, whenever you people feel any difficulty, raise hand so that I can see from the screen. Okay, keeping you muted is my helplessness, but you can always speak up through your gestures. Okay, when your hand is raised, you'll be there on the screen.
Am I right?
Okay. So, Divita, how are you? Okay, so indefinite, continuous. Next one is? Perfect. The next one is perfect continuous. Okay, there is never any use or there is never any need to learn the rules. Do you agree? There is never any need to learn the rules of the tenses. Do you agree or not? Do you agree? Tell properly. There is never any, you should not learn the rules. Am I right or wrong? Those here on screen, if you agree, raise hand. We should not learn the rules of tenses. How many of you agree? Raise hand. Okay. Yes, be your own self. Don't imitate others. You people say, okay, there should not, the rules should not be learned. Jayaditya. Chayang. Yeah. So this is what I'm saying. So they should be understood. So there is a logic behind the rules. And that logic, once you understand, there is never any need to learn the rules. Okay? So this is what we are going to learn today. What is indefinite about which there is no surety? I come to school. I daily come to school. What is surety over here? Do I come to school in the morning or do I come to school in the afternoon or do I come to school at night? Did I tell in my sentence? Is the time of coming to school fixed through my this sentence that I come to school daily? It's not fixed. That's why it is indefinite. So whenever there is indefinite tense, indefinite time, we take only the base form of the verb. If it is present indefinite, then it will be only V1. First form of verb, when it is present indefinite. When I say I study for 2 hours in the evening, what is indefinite over here? In the evening, I study for 2 hours. It's your routine. And you daily do it. And you want to talk about your present routine. Like presently, this is your routine. Whether you'll continue with this in the future, you don't know. But presently, as per your routine, you study for 2 hours in the evening. So why? What is indefinite about it? When you started this routine, whether you'll continue this with the, in the future or not, nothing is sure. At what time you do this exactly? Right now you are doing it or not, you don't know. But you do this. Maybe you will skip it today. Now you are telling me, ma'am, I study for 2 hours daily in the evening. And supposing in the evening you plan to go to Dalhousie, what will you do? It doesn't mean that you told me a lie. But that is your routine. And sometimes the routines are not followed. But that happens to be a broadly speaking routine. So there is some element of indefiniteness is there. Got it? So present indefinite, there only we use first form of verb. I study. I read a book every day before going to bed. I daily call my grandmother. I daily do yoga in the morning. So these are all indefinites. If I remove the word daily from here, even then the things would remain the same. So when I say present indefinite, V1. But when I say past indefinite, I went to school yesterday. I went to school yesterday. Or I came to school yesterday. And I was happy to see that many other friends had also come. I came to school yesterday. What is it? You know this is past indefinite. Children, my focus right now is not only to tell you the rules of the tenses. My focus is to tell you the functions of the tenses. Okay? Functions means the usage. I came to school yesterday. Whenever the words like yesterday or last come, blindly without thinking use past indefinite. Yesterday, with yesterday, or with a word like last. Without thinking use second form of verb. I came to school yesterday and was happy. Again, past indefinite was a second form of verb, and was happy to see that many other students, many other friends had come. Ab ye had come kyun aa gaya? Because they were already there before you came. You came and you saw they were there. So you were happy that they had come. So had come is perfect, past perfect. Because this action of your friends coming in the class happened before you came. So we'll come to that in details. But right now, let me focus upon indefinite. I came to school yesterday. I read a book on Abdul Kalam last year. Wherever last comes, use past indefinite. My mother spoke to me about my exams yesterday. Got it? Yesterday spoke. So with the past indefinite, use second form of verb. Right? Without any thinking. Third is future indefinite. What is future indefinite? About which you planned to do something. When you plan to do something, it is of course to be done in the future. Whatever your planning is, can you say that, ma'am, it was about the past? I will go to market in the evening. What is this? It's your planning. You have made up your mind. You have taken the decision. I will start coming to school regularly. What is it? Decision. And when it is your planning or decision, you use future indefinite. So what's the rule of future indefinite? Will or shall plus V1. First form of verb. Here you have to learn one common thing, that with the modals, maybe will, shall, would, should, can, could, may, might, always use first form of verb. This rule will help you in all the editing exercises. With all modals, use first form of verb. Many children get confused, ma'am, with will, we'll be using first form, but with would, we'll be using second form. No. With all modals. Okay, now you tell me, Rahul, which form of verb you will use with ought? Which form of verb will you use with the modal ought? Jayaditya is right. V1. I'm saying form of verb. And aap kya keh rahe hain? कोई बात नहीं, सिट डाउन, अभी इट विल टेक सम टाइम टू गियर अप, एम आई राइट? सो विच फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब यू विल यूज विद माइट? तरुणदीप, फर्स्ट फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब, बिकॉज विद ऑल मॉडल्स वी आर टू यूज V1, रिमेंबर इट. ओके, सो फ्यूचर इन, सो इनडेफिनेट टेंस इज ओवर, राइट? Present indefinite, past indefinite, future indefinite. Now all of you write 3 sentences using these 3 tenses. Come on. All of you write 3 sentences using 3 tenses. Have you written on screen, children? Yes, Thavresh, speak up all these sentences.
Yes. Ma'am, I go to school daily. Mm-hmm. I मैम फ्यूचर आई विल गो टू स्कूल एंड पास्ट आई वेंट टू स्कूल यस्टरडे.
या दैट इज करेक्ट. वेल डन. ओके फ्रॉम हियर नाउ दैट बॉय व्हाट्स हिज नेम. What's your name, beta? What did he say? Saket. Yes, Saket. Come on. Is it okay to say I go to market full stop? Do you say like this? I go to school full stop. Come on, do you say like this? What do you say? Yes. You have to add something like this. I go to school daily. Daily I go to school. Every day I go to school. Right? So add adverb to emphasize your action. It's not a rule. But when we speak something, it happens automatically. I study for 2 hours. Do you say like this? I study for 2 hours in the evening. You people say always, I always study for 2 hours. I daily study for 2 hours in the evening. Maybe you are cribbing about it. Maybe you are happy about it. That's a different issue. But most of the times you crib about it. I daily study for 2 hours. You are never happy about it. But the moment somebody says, I daily go for an ice cream in the evening, then your eyes, you know, they start shining. No? But the point is, daily comes. So they add, you know, some meaning to your language. They are not rules. That is how you become either very good speakers or you become very bad speakers. Right language makes you become popular. And the bad language makes you become notorious. Okay, some children are very, very, popular or famous in the among friends. And that is all because of their communication skills. You know, you can make out, see who is very famous among you. Don't tell me, ma'am, because of marks. You people don't ask marks. Am I right? You people say marks apne paas rakho aap. So you people become famous the way you communicate. Okay, some children are very humorous. You like them. Humor comes through language. Some children are very witty. That also comes through language. Some children are very expressionist. They speak with expression. You like them. You say like when that person speaks, uski to eyes bhi bolti hai. Right? So it's all about communication. It's all about language. Okay, I don't say like forget other things. But yes, communication very important. Give some time to it. Okay, sit down, Saket, beta, well done. So now let's come to the continuous tense. Yeah, wait. So what is the meaning of continuous? Continuous means something which is going on. What's the meaning of continuous? Something which is going on. So whenever we talk about the word continuous, there are two words, or I will say one word, which will come to your mind. What is that? V1 plus ing. V1 plus ing. You people did that as gerund also. Or it is participle. Gerund is the noun form of the V1 ing. When you say walking in the morning is my hobby. I go for walking in the morning. What is walking here? No, you just tell me, I go for walking in the morning. What is walking? Soch ke batao. I go for walking in the I go for walking in the evening. Thank you. Yeah, I go for walking in the evening. My question is, what is walking here? Anyone on screen can raise hand if you know. Verb. Is it verb? Is it noun? What is it? Is it action verb? I'm scaring you people. Now you think. You people think and tell what's it. Is it alphabet? Who said? Go to nursery and learn what are alphabets. Alphabets are A, B. Is it alphabet? Walking. It's a word. Okay. And what kind of word is it? Action word means you mean verb? Okay. It is made up of verb. It is made up of walk plus ing. It is made up of verb and ing, but it's not acting like a verb. It is acting like a, come on, noun. So it is a gerund. Got it? So when a verb acts like a noun, we call it gerund. Okay? So here walking is a gerund. It's not verb. Now I'm giving you one more example. I need a walking stick for my granny. I need a walking stick for my granny. Now, what is walking here? What is walking here? Walking stick is the full thing is noun. Are you sure? What is it? What is red shirt? Red shirt is adjective. Red is adjective and shirt is noun. Now tell me, what is it? Yes. Yes, stick is noun. And walking is? Lag raha hai adjective? It seems to be adjective. It is acting like adjective. But actually it is made up of verb. Okay, when the words are made up of verb plus ing, but is acting like adjective, we call it participle. Yes, we call it participle. Participles are the verbs which act like adjectives. Got it? They are always made up of V1 plus ing, or they are made up of anyone else? Yes, yes, Prabhu. Try. No, they are made up of V1 plus ing. But they act, they are always made up of V1 plus ing, or they are made up of one more thing. It's not always only V1. It is third form of verb. Let me give you one more example. It's a broken chair. Don't sit in it. Tell me now. Yeah, chair is a noun and broken is a participle. Why is it participle? Because yes, it is made up of third form of verb, but working like an adjective. So it is participle. So there are two kinds of participles. One is present participle, that is V1 plus ing, or there is third form of verb, that is past participle. Can you tell me the kinds of verbs? What are the different kinds of verbs? Forms of verbs I'm talking about. What are the forms of verbs? First form of verb is called as present verb. Second form of verb is called as past verb. Past. Third form of verb is called as past participle. third form broken, and fourth form of verb is called as present participle, V1 plus ing. How many forms of verbs are there? Four: present, past, past participle, present participle. Clear? And participles act like adjectives. Okay. So now participle and gerund's concept we have done side by side. But when we talk about continuous, in the continuous, when we put V1 plus ing, then we should remember that this V1 plus ing is neither gerund nor participle. They are proper verbs. I am doing my work. Doing over here is neither participle nor gerund. That is a proper verb. Is that clear? I am doing. How will you differentiate between a proper verb and participle and gerund? Anyone? How will you differentiate between proper verb? For example, proper verb. Yes. Theek hai. Kritika? She's right. My question was like, how will you differentiate between proper verb and gerund participle? The answer is proper verbs change according to the helping verbs. If I talk about present tense, then I'll be saying I am doing my work. Okay, there you can say helping verbs or the auxiliary verbs, they change with them. But with participles, it's not so. They are rarely affected by the verbs. It is a broken chair. It was a broken chair. It doesn't make any difference with the meaning of the broken word. But here the tense changes. I am doing my work. I did my work. I have done my work. So their changes are going on in the verb. But in gerunds and participles, changes don't happen. Is that clear? So we were talking about continuous tense with V1 plus ing. When continuous comes, V1 plus ing will be there. So if we talk about present continuous, present means first form of verb. It means is, am, are, plus V1 plus ing. I am doing my work. I am writing an essay. Don't disturb me now. Have you written your essays, which I asked you people to write? Send me. Chayank, you have not sent me your essay yet. Chayank. Okay, I'll check. I don't think you've sent. Okay, I'll see. Kindly send your essays today by all means. By evening, I'll wait. Okay? Those who've been personally asked, they will definitely do it. Those who've not been personally asked, I'll be rather happier if they do it. Okay? And some children are sending me when they were not personally asked. They are sending the essays. Okay, these things are kept in mind. Okay? So when you people are given the assessments later on, they are kept in mind, like how many children follow us? How many children do the work in time? Okay, because these are your linguistic tasks. I'm not asking you to sing a song. I'm not asking you to play a violin. I'm giving you a job out of your subject. Okay. So I am doing my work, present continuous. And what about past continuous? Was or were. Past means second form of verb. And second form of verb is, what's the second form of ismr? Was, were. Actually, ismr, was, were, and been are all the cousins of be. Yes. Be is of eldest brother. Eldest sibling, you can say. Be se baki log a gaye, uske siblings chote a gaye. Ismr, was, were, been. Okay, be is a base verb. Be ke real brother sisters are ismr, cousins are was, were, aur uske agle cousins are, cousin is been. When we say past continuous, it means was, were, plus V1 plus ing. But when we say future continuous, for the word future, which word comes to your mind? will or shall. Write down the rule for future continuous. Will or shall plus with will or shall, we always use first form of verb. Be. Will or shall plus be plus V1 plus ing. Shall I ask anyone any rule out of these three? Present continuous is MR plus V1 plus ing. Past continuous is was or were plus V1 plus ing. Future continuous is will or shall plus be plus V1 plus ing. Right? Now make three examples, three sentences of these three tenses. I am doing my work now. I was writing an essay yesterday. I will send the essay to teacher today. And I'll mail the essay today. And anything you can write. Yes, Arshin, speak up your three examples. Yes, Arshin. Bell has gone earlier. Come on, children, write down three examples. Okay. Yes, Rahul, speak the answers. I'll be playing. Okay. So I was playing yesterday when no offline classes had started. Now I am sitting in the class and have to study. And I will not be coming to school tomorrow because it's too much. Isn't it, Rahul? No? Okay. I'm just joking. Okay, children, I guess this much is enough for the day. Tomorrow we'll continue.